Trucking veteran Steve Graham's heading to the beach.
It's really unusual for me in my life to actually get to a beach somewhere.
But it's no vacation.
You do anything silly out here, you pay for it.
The coast is a bone-crunching 600 kilometres away, at the very top of Australia. Steve must conquer the treacherous Gibb River Road to get there. It's notorious for eating trucks alive.
Idle along, grit your teeth.
On the outskirts of Kununurra, Steve hitches up the road train. He's on a rescue mission for two good mates. Hundreds of kilometres away, husband and wife trucking team Joe and Nick Atkins are in strife on the edge of the continent.
We've all got a truck down at the moment with the wheel bearing and just too much work on. We've got Steve to do this run for us.
Steve gave us our very first job 10 years ago.
And they want a hand, well, we'll head over there and see what we can do for them.
To deliver the favour, Steve will travel over 600 tyre-crunching kilometres from Kununurra in Western Australia to an isolated camping ground near Kalumburu. Steve needs all his skills.
Pretty rough, this one.
Refined over 40 years behind the wheel.
I reckon I'm getting off this bloody road onto another worse road.
If he's to conquer this truck-killing road.
And then you get the odd local customer like him and he ain't scared of nothing.
Steve's cargo is massive. Five shipping containers, fully loaded with building materials and fuel.
This is the last bits of it.
His faithful companion Bella is along for the ride, back on the road after busting two of her ribs.
Righto. Oh, well, that's good. I've got everything chained down and I'm on the road again.
Steve knows Joe and Nick's reputation is on the line. He has to win this battle with the notorious Gibb River Road.
It's the end of that beautiful bitumen and the start of the bloody corrugations. We've got 600 kilometres to go.
And every one of them a bone-shaking and load-bashing ordeal to endure.
Here we go. There's the Pentecost River down there. It's giving it a bit of pain here and there.
Steve Graham's mercy dash to help out mates Nick and Joe has turned into a major shakedown.
You can hear some of the rocks banging up underneath us.
Steve has 40 years' experience as a trucker, but with a rig 53 and a half metres long, weighing 90 tonnes.
Well, that's what it is, all big round boulders down there, churning up, spitting out.
The river crossing is a huge test.
The trailer's through there, 62.
Rock fragments, sharp as spears, can jag a tyre and bring him to a grinding halt.
The worry is that the little round rocks get between the jewels. Righto, I better go and check that there's no rocks between my wheels. Let the dog have a drink in the creek. Watch out for crocodiles, doggy.
While Steve checks his 62 tyres survived the crossing, Bella keeps an eye out for unwanted visitors. The tyres are intact, but the rough crossing has shaken Steve's load.
Look at that. This one's moved across. You wouldn't think it would do it, but they do it.
Back on the road. Back to hours of grueling corrugations. The treacherous Gibb is taking its toll.
Oh, I don't know what's going on now. I've got brakes come on somewhere back there. Better have a look at what's going on here. You see the brakes locked on and skidding down the road. This brake here appears to be the problem.
It's a major brake failure that can only be fixed from underneath the truck. With only two of the truck's 16 brakes locked on, it's a dangerous task.
Now, I really don't like doing this, getting under a trailer on a hill like this, but...
Steve takes out a little extra insurance. A rock and two brakes are all that stand between Steve and disaster. If anything slips, he's a goner.
What was that noise?
He can't figure out why his air brakes have seized and locked the wheels. If Steve can't unlock his brakes, he could be stranded here for days.
Oh, I don't want to move. You husky. I found the problem. I had a maxi booster replaced on this trailer. The hose clamp obviously wasn't tightened up properly, and it's just dropped the hose clamp. And this particular brake here has got no air going to it, so the maxi's locked on.
The simple hose clamp is just the latest victim of the corrugated road.
Well, that's that sorted, I think. A silly little 50-cent, 75-cent hose clamp, you know? Into the jump-up country now.
In the outback, jump-ups are slang for steep hills.
We're getting a bit closer to that mongrel theta jump-up now.
The theta jump-up is one of Steve's nemesis. 350 metres of nerve-wracking climb.
I am going to have a crack at it with the three trailers.
To deliver on time, Steve is about to attempt something he's never done before.
Get myself in the lowest of my lower gears. Engage all of my diff locks and cross locks.
Pull three trailers, nearly 100 tonnes, up in one go.
It's loose surface now, it's scary.
Make it, and he'll succeed where many have failed.
This is where it gets scary. And the whole road train's committed to the slope now.
In the far northwest, on a mercy dash for mates, Steve Grahame is attempting something he's never done before.
This is where it gets scary.
Hauling three trailers and nearly 100 tonnes up the treacherous feeder jumper. ...350 metres of steep incline.
I've got to try and pick that bit between wheel spin and stall out.
He needs all the grunt of his 600 horsepower engine.
As I feel the rough bits of ground, I just ease off on the throttle ever so slightly. And of course, here's the mongrel bit up in front of me, this nasty little pinch. It's loose surface now, it's scary as.
If the wheels start spinning, his massive rig will be stranded on the hill.
Oh, I just had wheel spin. Every now and then I feel those wheels just start to break traction. She's hanging on.
Feeder.
That's the first time in my trucking career I've pulled three up here.
Is finally conquered. On the notorious Gibb River Road, Steve's truck is bashed and bruised.
Well, it's good to be nearly there.
But not beaten. A grueling journey ends with a welcome reunion.
Hey, how you going?
Trucking mates Nick and Joe are thrilled to see Steve and his load make it to the coast in one piece.
How are you, love? You good? Oh, this is good. I get two cutters. Right, well, there you go. There's the ocean just over there. You know, Australia's a bloody big country, but I finally got to one end of it.
Steve has called on all his skills to defeat one of Australia's toughest roads.
That's the last container off. The job's done. It's really unusual for me in my life to actually get to a beach somewhere and to be able to sit back and enjoy good friends and look out over the ocean.
An outback legend has earned the right to kick back and relax.